afternoon. I have the simplest task of keeping you all awake after lunch. Thank you. So, I'm from MSC Software, and we believe in simulating reality, but we are extending that and asking you, or asking ourselves, look who's driving today, tomorrow, and for the decades to come. So I'm part of MSC for last decade, and I'm pleased to, you know, be part of this event representing this beautiful company. We started our journey 55 years back, supporting NASA in its race to send a man on the moon, race against Russia, obviously. From then on, we have helped the mankind across the world to reach many targets, the latest being sending a rover on the Mars. And in between, we did provide the tools, mathematical tools, physics-based tools, to do various kinds of stuff, be it, you know, safety of an airplane when a bird hits the engine, or the safety of personnel in an armored tank, or passengers in a vehicle. When you keep doing good stuff, you get a lot of loyal customers, most of, you know, many of whom are here today. So this is what we have been doing for the last 55 years. So what next? Where are we going? Now we are redefining where the simulation technologies is going, right? Every company talks about lightweighting. Every company talks about new manufacturing technologies like additive manufacturing, so on and so forth. So that is one area where we are looking at. But why me and my colleagues are here today? I'm sure in every OEM or a startup or, you know, component, tier one manufacturer, the discussion is based on two, or centered on two aspects: electric vehicle mobility and autonomous vehicle engineering. So this is what is driving the discussion, and that is why we are all here today. So my motivation to be here today is to discuss on this. And while we are all talking, you know, big dreamy stuff, the harsh reality is this. The panelists before lunch mentioned that, you know, the international media headlines is that people are getting killed in autonomous test vehicles. Okay, so while the dream for every CEO or every consumer is to relax, sit back and enjoy his drive, we are far from it. But where we are though today, to an extent, is this. There's a child crossing the road, and there is a heavy truck coming from the other side of the road. Okay? Reaction time, 150 milliseconds, completely controlled by the autonomous or the active safety system on board. In fact, one of the panelists did take the name of this vehicle. I don't want to, you know, take the name again, but this is where we are today. Okay, but this is a very predictable scenario, right? But when you want to take it to the next level, the harsh realities, or, you know, a lot of things do start coming in. Freeway conditions are good, but then you have complex traffic conditions, people moving around, vehicles overtaking each other, and, you know, different way of road signs, different traffic standards, because nobody builds a vehicle for one city or one country alone anymore. It's all global. And different level of automation with the final aim of achieving level 5. So what are the challenges that we face as a simulation technology provider today? There are very limited test scenarios that we can offer to our customers, you know, in the traditional simulation technologies. The inherent aspect of our simulation tools restricts the hardware-in-loop and driver-in-loop concepts, and the certification, you know, who owns the certification. So these are the challenges that we face when we talk to our customers. Everybody has gone through these levels of autonomy, but a different perspective. Starting from right to left, not the other way, you know, we are talking about the level 5 on the left-hand side and you know, going down. It just shows the level of user interaction with the vehicle. As somebody said, you know, even today we have one hand on the steering wheel and one hand on the gear and, you know, one mobile in between the ear and shoulder. So these are all the challenges, right? And what is the responsibility of the system in terms of, you know, at each level of autonomy that you're looking at? The green representing the user. As you go more and more autonomous, the system takes over. And what is the responsibility of the judiciary or the entire ecosystem in such a scenario? So this is from our perspective. If I have to, you know, go to OEM and start talking to them on autonomous vehicle engineering. So today, what do we do? A kid hits 16 years. He goes to his father. He says, OK, I want the learning license. We identify the nearest driving school. He goes there. We identify the best instructor. And you know, he just first theory, stop, go, all the stuff. Then he takes on to the road, first maybe simulator, then to the road. Then finally one test, which RTO, you know, you can get it done. And you get the license, come onto the road. Now, if I have to replace this guy with something very, you know, system driven, what do I need to do? I need to build the same human brain or better through an artificially intelligent driver. So I need to teach this AI driver to think like a human brain or better than that. So I need to take away the entire driving school up to, you know, the road testing done through the AI driver. So what has the industry decided on today? We have Maruti, you know, VE, MBRD, everybody. Everybody is sure of one thing. If I need to train that AI driver, there are only two ways. One is I do road test, right? But how much road test can you do? 200, 300,000 kilometers, maybe half a million. You can do a track test, 1 million. But is it enough to train the driver to take all those decisions? No, right? So the only, not alternative, but only supporting role that can be you know, called in is through simulation. That's where we come in. So it has been an accepted norm in ADAS and you know, autonomous engineering that a combination of hard testing and simulation is the way to go forward. So the analysis says that you need to test or take the AI through a billion miles of different scenarios being tested. So can we do that? Okay? To have a realistic time frame that you know, you and me can one day sit in a driverless car and you know, wait through the Bangalore traffic. So shorten the time, can we test for billion kilometers? Now, what do we need if we have to do? Let's start designing a tool, right? I need to start building the road, basic road, paved road, cemented road, whatever. Then I put the one more lane, I put the external factor of you know, somebody else driving. So I create the environment. Then I need a system that will tell me if somebody is taking a turn from this side to that side, basically the operating conditions or the environment, which will manage the entire scenario. Then I need those eyes, you know, the perception cameras, you know, the stimulators. You know, it may be something to you know, detect somebody crossing the road or change in the lighting or traffic signal. So the perceptive cameras, which can either stimulate or just observe. Then I solve it, take the data, analyze the data, visualize it. So this is what you need if you want to make use of a software. So starting from the basic road to a downtown scenario with buildings, to highway, you know, with a lot of interchanges and things like that, and getting into, again, details like parking, conscious of the neighboring vehicles or the buildings, and traffic system, finally non-vehicle, like policeman on a horse or a cow crossing the road or whatever it is. So you need to have the tool which can build all this realistic environment. Once I do that, I put the sensors and the perceptive cameras. As I said, you know, something should can be only to visualize, like a fisheye camera or a pinhole camera or 360 degree camera. But some are physics based you know, rendering cameras. I hope you can see on the right side, on the top, it's actually a road with puddles of water, right? If I have to train that AI driver, how will I tell the driver that AI system, that is the building, what you're seeing is a reflection of that building in the water? Or in the night time, how do I tell the system that is the light from the room, it is 20 feet above the road, what you're seeing is reflection of the road? You don't have to stop, right? You can move on. So the system should be powerful enough to get those data and train that AI driver. Then you have the perception stimulators. Like, simple example is your proximity sensors. You know, an action which will invoke a reaction from the system. So there are several of them, you know, radars, ladders, and, you know, lot of them. So the system should be robust enough to actually give you the flexibility that can represent the complexities on the road. Now I put all this together, I start solving. It can be a simple steering on a highway, or two lane, you know, with a change with a brake, emergency brake, or you know, overtaking, traffic jam, slow down, start, so on and so forth. So what we have been doing at MSC is, through a company of ours, a subsidiary called Vires, based out of Germany, we are building a set of tools, software tool chain, which are very modular and customizable, primarily aimed at creating, you know, animating is like solving, perception is like, you know, perceiving, and managing various scenarios for software in loop, driver in loop, hardware in loop, you name it. Okay, what the final aim of development of you know, test validation of highly automated driving system. So this is what we have been doing at MSC. And obviously, every technology has a benefactor, right? And autonomous, I think, is mostly European OEM driven. And it's no wonder that Vires also comes from Germany. And we are party to some of the, you know, inter OEM funding, you know, like OpenGR and, you know, the standards, and also government backed initiatives like Pegasus. So there is a lot of credibility and you know, say from Vires in this entire direction that we are taking. But you know what, at the end of the day, simulation people are the last people, you know, to say that I have replaced testing. I can never replace testing. I can replace to an extent, but never fully. So you always want the entire ecosystem to work, right? So you still need a doctor to tell the robot how to perform the surgery. You know, the robot cannot take the decision on its own. In the same way, you need a host of things to happen perfectly in a synchronized manner for the best outcome. So we at MSC, along with our parent Hexagon AB, are just not looking at a chain of software tools, but also looking at the entire picture. Adams, which is our you know, flagship multi-body dynamics tool for 3-4 decades, it helps you look at vehicle dynamics. But if you want to take the inputs of the vehicle dynamics, like how the vehicle will behave in a certain situation, you need to make it 100 times faster, or no, more than 100 times faster, what we call as real time, and more than real time plus, which gets fed into Vires. But then it churns so much data. You need a data management tool, you need an analytics tool, and you need a machine learning platform to make sense out of this data and get the data that is of relevance. Now, once I have that, I still need to do the physical testing, right? So I need the best of the sensors, Leica, which everybody knows is part of our company. Then we offer geospatial and, you know, telematics. Hexagon is known for that, to give the data on the 3D environment, which gets fed into the ADAS system. And finally, once we have this, we just acquired a company called Autonomous Stuff, which basically gives the kit, ADAS kit, to the customer, which they can, you know, fit into their existing vehicle and convert it to an ADAS vehicle. So this is what we are looking at. While we keep focusing on the verticals of creating the best-in-class software tools, we also try to look at, you know, how everything fits together so that a few months down the line, we are not again talking about, you know, car crashes, but hopefully we have a better end to the day. This is, of course, fantasy, but fantasies do come true. With that, thanks a lot. Oh, we acknowledge the logo and the content of the respective owners because it has come from a lot of people. Thank you, and this is, as I said, conceptualized stuff. This is not Marathalli or Whitefield. That I still, you know, we have time to go there. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, sir, for a knowledge enhancing session. We really enjoyed this session. Thank you.